Howdy. Now, Shamrock, tell me a little bit about yourself.
I'm 19.
Okay. 19.
Make sure to speak up. It is very loud in here.
Yes. 19, you're a furry. What brought you to the furry fandom? Is the eternal question why everyone asks.
It was when I first saw a furry was.
You just instantly fell in love with it?
Yeah.
That's the same thing that happened to him too.
Uh-huh. So, you said previous conversations we were having, you said that you go to meetups and whatnot.
Actually looking for some local furry meetups. We don't know where they are.
we don't really know where to go.
There's one in Jacksonville. Actually, I have the picture of the address.
Can you use your phone to take a picture of it?
Absolutely.
I'll have to find it.
We'll do that in a moment. It's fine.
Okay, that's fine.
So, do you like to go to regular meetups? Awesome. They're a lot of fun.
Well, the one in Jacksonville was my first one.
Okay.
I haven't been to one yet, but I went to the squad.
So, tell me a little bit about your fursuit in your sauna. Because most people don't understand what fursuiting is, what it means, to be a furry. Most people think it's just degenerate furry nonsense.
Well, it is degenerate furry nonsense, but it's also other things.
Well, that's only one part of the story.
Indeed.
Which most of the radio broadcasters don't seem to care about. They just say, oh, weird funny thing. You're the star of the show.
Indeed you are. In fact, why don't we, when we go back to our vehicle, why don't we grab my fox head? And then we can perform a wonderful show with our new friend.
I love it.
That would be very fun.
So, tell me a little bit more about your sauna and how you came up with the design.
Well, so I started making more designs. I actually have three more furry suits.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, I have a black dog one. That was my first one.
Is it a Labrador?
It's the same mask as this, but it's just black.
Is it an Abracadabrador?
I'll show you.
Cute!
Because
I also have
my partner is a Labrador, and therefore a black dog is something that he would greatly enjoy.
I also have a dragon suit, too.
Ooh!
And then I also have a Christmas dog.
A Christmas dog?
Yeah.
Can you explain to the audience what a Christmas dog is? I'm sure that it would be very interesting.
So it's one that I made, but I have right here.
Yeah.
On the right side of the mouth, it's the green. And the other side is red, so it's kind of opposite.
Oh, okay, cool.
Yeah.
I love it.
Yeah.
It's recharging, sir.
Carson, look down here. Look. Look down here, Carson. Look down here.
Cute!
Look at this.
Oh, yeah. Very cute.
Here, let me go look and you can wear them.
They have some special.
I don't really want. It's fine. So, let's see. So, what are your thoughts on the furry fandom as a whole?
I don't know.
You don't know much about it, or are you just kind of surface level, but with a fursuit?
I just kind of, I don't know. Yeah, but here's my dragon one.
I have a wealth of information about it, but I always enjoy hearing other people's opinions.
Yeah. I see you want to play against the legend.
Let's see. Do, 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 do,
do, do, do. This suit took me a week to make.
Oh, very cool. So you learned how to make it through what? YouTube, TikTok, what?
YouTube.
Cool.
Too late.
Eva!
Do you do pictures? Would you care to come by my girls so I can get a picture? Please.
I see.
Yes.
He is the star of the show. What? What
it's
is it?
Perfect. For our
the solar system.
It's the solar system planetarium. Assemble your own planetarium model. Paint it and add highlights to create the glow effect. Watch the 30-centimeter model. Oh, glow in the dark. It's out of this world.
Do you have any questions for our fine furry friend?
My question is, Shamrock.
Yes.
I have a question for you after this commercial break.
Thank you. Hold the back of the wheelchair so it doesn't move, okay?
Okay.
I was saying. Right, healthy sticks.
Great. Are you cheering for me or are you cheering for somebody behind me? This is your first time? First timers! If this is your first time being here, make some noise. We want to hear from you. That's awesome. Thank you so much for being here and welcome to Hot Springs National Park, Arkansas. We are proud to own the world record for the world's shortest St. Patrick's Day Parade. You know, there are several cities across this country who try to claim it, but we all know we are the only ones who know how to do a real, short, St. Patrick's Day parade. That's
Thank you.
other stuff.
Going to the restroom at the same time. That means they're following the mentality of a cat, which means that they're cat people.
I didn't have to tell you these. And I didn't tell them that I was a public teacher.
Also, this is very unwieldy for me to use. It's perfect for you. It's a perfect. Did you? It is a perfect dyslexia writing device. Now, tacos. 3 for $10. Okay?
Yep.
That's probably what I'm going to get. Let's see. Taco dinner. Burrito. Southwest salad, spring mix salad, corn, black beans, feta cheese, tomatoes. Let's see. Tacos, 3 for $10. Okay. So we are going to choose 6 tacos. Okay? I will have 3, and you will have 3. Okay? Yours, you will mark in blue. Okay?
Okay, what are the other food options?
I will read you the other options, but I guarantee you, this is when you're going to pick, okay? Now, here you go. Tacos, tamale, stuffed jalapenos, street corn, nachos, chips and salsa, cheese dip, quesadilla, southwest salad, tortillaki, carnitas, taco dinner, mixed burrito.
Wow, the quesadilla sounds lovely.
Okay, Mr. Preparian.
Mr. Who?
All right. Quesadilla rica, 10-inch flour tortilla served with pico, avocado, sour cream, side of cilantro rice, and charro or black beans. Is that what you want?
That sounds awesome.
Okay.
Indifferent.
Go right ahead. Okay. Tacos, 3 for $10. Okay. Tilapia shrimp. Okay, definitely not shrimp. Tilapia shrimp, so I definitely want one of those. That would be number one. Beef barbacoa, pork, castor, cactus, no. Vegetable, no. Pork belly, no. Carne asada. Chorizo? Absolutely. So, grilled chicken or steak? Okay. Ribeye? Yes, please. That sounds awesome. Number two. And
Okay. And to drink. What do you want?
I will do Sprite.
Sprite?
Yeah, no ice.
Sprite, no ice? Just one moment. Drinks. D-R-I-N-K-S. For Mr. Fox. Number one, Sprite, no ice. Number two, milk. Number three, ice water. With lemon.
Oh, thank you so much.
Okay. So. Focus. What do you want?
Okay.
Yep. This is what I want. These three.
Okay.
Okay. Give that, plus this to them, and that's our order, okay?
Okay.
Just give it to them.
Hey, boss. How are you?
Good, how are you?
Nice to be here.
Take it, please.
She's right here.
I don't know if I am going to be the one taking care of you, but I can probably pass this along.
Okay.
If you could just give this to our server, please.
Okay.
We just made it easy for him.
Okay.
Okay. Now,
where's your
set up over the weekend?
Yes.
Focus. Okay. Read these words. Do the pencil. What is this word?
Donation for Arkansas Children's Hospital.
Okay. Now the reason why we're going to do that is because there are literally thousands of businesses that raise money for Arkansas Children's.
Yes.
Now, next time, you get official permission from them.
Yes.
But the permission is very easy to get.
Correct.
So no one at the parade will be like, well, why are you raising money for Arkansas Children? It's not going to be an issue. Okay? Also, I went there about 7 dozen times as a child, so it is a cause that is important to me.
I agree.
Okay? So, we are going to be raising money and taking donations of goods for Arkansas Children's Hospital. Okay?
Okay.
Now, we are going to need to go back to the registration table to get our box, because the box is still there, probably with a very distressed tailor. Okay? So after we eat, that's where we need to go next. And we need to take the box to the car, because it's much too heavy to be carrying it out. And then we need to choose what items we are going to bring back with us as we walk around and take donations. Okay? Because I know the regulations.
So I can get you guys everything you need, but it may just be a few minutes. Normally, like, if you come in through the back, just make sure to let the hostess still know that you're here so we can assign you a server in the future. Because today we're actually on a really long wait list. So the tables that we do have are supposed to be reserved. But it's okay, because you're here and we know you, so it's all right. Just allow me a few minutes and I'll get you everything you need, okay?
Sounds great.
Like, we wouldn't ignore you on purpose.
Sorry for the confusion.
We just may not know, you know, because we're so busy if you don't tell someone. So.
Yeah, we'll let you know next time.
All right,
thank you. Okay, so we are going to walk around. And people will just throw money at us.
I think being their best customer. We just do whatever the fuck. We just walk in.
Uh-huh.
And then they throw us out.
Uh-huh. I'm not sure if I'm going to be your server. Take our order and give it to our server.
Figure it out.
Figure it out. You're going to be your best customer. Figure it out.
Figure it out.
Okay.
Because not a difficult task.
That's your job, is to take our order. So, thank you very much. I appreciate it. Okay. Now,
Busiest day of the year, who's walking?
Because if you walk in like you own the place, then you might as well own the place. Because I would love to purchase this restaurant at some point. And change nothing about it. Just give it more customers. Because we are the opposite of new supervisoritis. We find places we like, and then we say, I would like to purchase this place, please. And I do not want to change anything about it, other than the payment system.
Or we find places we like, and we say, this place is abandoned. What? It is the worst building in the nicest part of town.
Correct.
Nobody wants it.
Nobody wants it, and I do.
So, 100 grand. What did you have so much money in that?
How did you make so much money? Well, I opened my eyes, and I looked around and saw money everywhere. That's how I've always done business, and it's been exceptionally successful.
Me, as a puppy,
I got puppy.
I don't care about that shit.
About what shit?
I open my eyes and I find people that need puddles.
Absolutely.
Never.
Alright, now my dear. We are going to start filling this with items.
Yep.
We're seeing the tip jar, okay? Mm-hmm. So grab the backpack and place it right here, or actually place it on the table, please.
It's about half
the price of these anyway. Thank you. Take an old floor table. Not one of the nice ones. One of the nice ones.
Really? That should be our motto. Don't change anything. It's great the way it is. Go ahead.
They always do all add to us. Our chair. Around.
I love it.
We'll add chairs around.
That sounds great. Let's do it. I see what you mean. Okay, got it. Here you go. I'm listening.
You get a white bird?
Okay. I can't make billions of dollars if you're dead.
Pattern.
Yep.
And then we get it custom built. And then we just put it on home.
I like it. Let's do it.
There. And we have enough space for everyone.
Okay.
See around it.
Yep.
And it's a whiteboard, so you can use your whiteboard
markers. I love it! We are creating a system that can be used by any teacher anywhere in the world. That is a fantastic thing, and it will be a great gift to the world. Everyone will be happy to pay us on something like Patreon because we are creating something to give away to poor students and teachers.
If we eventually we'll have a digital table set up.
Absolutely.
We'll take a old TV screen. One of the big old flat screens or whatever.
Yep.
Put lay that down like a table.
Yep.
Put a plexiglass above it.
Yep.
Build a, have a frame built and whatnot.
Yep, I'm listening.
We might even be able to mention the guys in the robot. All about robots.
That is so cool. I love it. Yes, absolutely.
Because he's a fucking engineer.
He is, and his talents are currently being wasted on projects by his wife. The only reason why he is wasting his time is because that is what she wants to do. And it's perfectly fine to do that, but he knows that he is wasting his time. I saw it in his face. He doesn't want to be doing this. He wants to be working for Google or whatever. Now, he didn't say that in words, but I saw it in his face. He doesn't want to be there. No. And meanwhile, she is so stressed out of her mind that she can't see money walking through her door. Oh, you have to fill it out. It's your life. I asked a week ago for an ADA accessibility request.
Oh, we don't have any physical.
The fact that you have not complied with the request in the course of a year is illegal. Now, I'm not going to take you to court because they are a very small business and do not deserve a lawsuit. But if necessary, I verify that as a client. And when the Justice Department calls them, the Justice Department will not give our names. They will only say, you just need to confirm what the section is like, and so you need to change what you're doing.
You don't need physical application.
That's bullshit.
Why not?
That's bullshit.
No, you can't.
And if you can't see that, that's not my problem. I want to work for you for free.
We'll open up our own fucking store.
If they can't see money walking through their door, we'll do what they're doing, but better, right next to them. And then they will get more business, and so everyone wins. It's not a zero-sum game. Everyone wins.
And we may open 6 days a fucking week. And we'll have some staff. We can't find any staff!
OPU is 45 minutes away. You think there's people who don't need summer jobs there? Idiots?
You haven't been asking people.
If the methods that you are using are not working, change your method.
Most small business owners don't understand.
That's one of the biggest problems I saw in small businesses was,
oh, well, we can't find any staff.
Well, what are you doing to find staff?
Well, I put an ad in the paper.
For an engineering job? Great idea. That's genius. That's literally what one of them did.
I can't find staff.
Really?
Really?
For an ice cream place? For an ice cream place? There's a dozen people down the fucking road that we wouldn't have to fucking bring.
Wait, do you see how many homeless people there are here? How about this? Take the homeless guy. Take him to the barber shop. Take him to Goodwill. Get him a suit. And say, you can work for me as long as you don't do drugs. You'll be drug tested once a week. You'll be paid $20 an hour for 1 week. And if you do a good job, you can stay. If you don't do a good job, you have to leave. And you better believe he's going to be the best fucking employee you've ever had. Because now, he doesn't look like a homeless person. He looks like a guy in a suit. You're welcome, my dear. That was talking about you.
Well, my dear.
I look better. You certainly do. You look like, not $1 million, because $1 million is bullshit. You look like $1 billion. Or $1 trillion. Is that salsa ready?
It was.
We're gonna ask for some.
I know.
Good boy. I just didn't know if you were eating it still or not. Usually when I put food in front of you, it was gone within 5 seconds. Oh my god! And by the way, will anyone question the name Satoshi Nakamoto if I go to a Mexican restaurant and eat his salsa? No! This is how I prefer to eat! And if they don't like it, they can go fuck themselves. This is going to get really loud for me. I'm going to have to put these on. Hold on, sir. My dear, it is really loud in here. I'm going to have to put these on. If you want my attention, you're going to have to speak up really loudly, okay?
I've reached a point in my life where I stop explaining things to people.
Because the law says you don't have to. So why do you worry about what other people think? Especially people who make 10 times less an hour than you.
And I tell your mother everything.
You think I give a shit? The people who are like,
how dare you be rude to me?
Well, I can pay $350 for whatever. How much do you get paid? Because my time is worth $350 on call because I did exceptionally well. Go ahead.
I've come to realize that I greatly appreciate you taking the stairs to do things on your own without me.
I appreciate the help.
My mother brought up an excellent point. That is important for both of us. Our own people do the same thing.
Yeah, that's very important.
And two, for us to come to the middle and come to common ground on various topics.
Your mother is very intelligent.
Uh-huh.
So, she does that is exactly what I've been trying to tell you for years.
Well, I wish it, by the way. Well, thank you.
I don't ask you to turn I ask you to tell. This is great. Mr. wearing an extra large t-shirt and expecting to have a spectacle. This is you. You wore the extra large t-shirt because that was what was comfortable to you at the time. That was what was convenient. Not what was comfortable to your goal.
Yeah, I'm a nurse.
Correct. And if we promote the town and get 10 times more customers to the town, the national park gets 10 times more budget.
Correct.
So it's a win-win-win-win-win-win. No one loses in this situation. Of course we will. Why not?
I don't know if that one's going to help you or not. Here's my solar panels. Solar panels, battery array. And then from there, we go to our friends over at the...
Sandlore?
Yes. We go to the Sandlore.
Any excess power that we produce, it doesn't come to the city, it goes to producing Bitcoin.
Right.
And we will not be selling power for 7 cents a kilowatt. We will be selling Bitcoin for $70,000 per coin that we earn.
Correct.
We have a lot more money that way. And especially if there is some type of electromagnetic attack across the entire country. Because we will harden our electrical grid against it.
Correct.
And so, Darwin, if we are the only people in the world with the ability to mine Bitcoin, here, have all the money in the world.
There we go. Okay, I'm part of the 1%. Next question.
I don't think you understand how the 1% works. 1% is $600,000 a year, my dear.
Right?
Yeah. Thank you very much. Okay. If you would please, I would like to give you these for the staff to thank them for their excellent service.
Thank you.
You know,
it's
absolutely.
1% is a Tuesday.
How do you care? 1% is for bullshitters.
We're the fractional
person. 1%. Don't insult me, Michael. 1% means... Okay, let me do the math for you real quick, okay? Because I want you to understand percentages a little bit better.
Yeah.
Okay? So... Okay, how many people live in this town? 30,000.
Yeah.
Okay.
to 30,000 people. Okay? Now, cross out two zeros. Okay? Okay, so we crossed out two zeros. So the number is 300. See?
Yeah.
Are there 300 people in this town that are running for president? Are there 300 people in this town that have built a multi-million dollar business multiple times? Are there multiple people, are there people in this town who get paid $350 an hour?
So,
if you take off another zero, that is 0.01%. Sorry, 0.1%. So, this, 1%. Would be 300. Okay? 0.1% would be 30.
Mm-hmm.
Now, why don't we do another one? Okay? So, 3 people would be 0.1%.